Ani, Gida Miigwangkwe, Indigenous, Spotted Feather Woman. My name is Melissa Waitner, and I was born on January 9th, 1970, on my grandmother's birthday. I was the first child of three born to Connie and Carl. They married as teenagers and were young, loving, and dedicated parents. I had a wonderful childhood. I was loved, respected, and taught right from wrong. I did well in school, loved music, and excelled at singing and playing the saxophone. I tried cigarettes and alcohol for the first time when I was 14 years old. I partied on the weekends since I was 16 and through college. I never correlated that my drinking caused my academic probation. In the fall of 1988, when I came home for a visit from college, I overheard my mom and my sister saying that my dad was an alcoholic. I was angry. How could they say such things? Alcoholics don't care about their family. They don't work, are abusive, and spend up all the money. That was not my dad. My dad worked two jobs, was on the Board of Education. He took care of us. Everyone's dad drank after work and on the weekends. I got married when I was 23 and was gifted with a son, Darby, in 1994 and Henry in 1995. In retrospect, I was a single mom. I worked hard, was devoted to my children, and only partied when the boys were with their dad. I never had alcohol in my house. In September of 2002, I had bariatric surgery. I was about 120 pounds overweight and was sick of it. I obsessed over food all the time. 3 months later, I had my first drink after the surgery. It felt great. A few nights later, I had a few more drinks. And within 2 months, I was drinking every night. At 6 months, I was blacking out nearly every night. I went to rehab in 2010, and I learned that I transferred my addiction from food to alcohol. Statistically, the percentage of people who have addiction transfer is staggering. In 2007, I was given my third gift, my son Cameron. Later that year, I had to have a surgical procedure and was given pain medication. I was the type of person who would never even finish a prescription, but I remember sitting on the couch after taking the pain meds and feeling warmth and happiness and thinking, wow, I feel great. These meds are the answer to my alcoholism. Problem solved, right? But pills run out. I tried to find pills any way I could get them, and if I couldn't, I would always go back to the bottle. I remember thinking, how the hell could I become an alcoholic addict so much later in life? I did a family tree once on the number of relatives that struggled like I did. It was devastating. I spent years drinking and drugging, in and out of detox, rehabs, jail, hospitals, and having overdoses. Many mornings I didn't want to wake up, but I couldn't follow through with it. I was the child of an alcoholic, married an alcoholic, and then became an alcoholic. I prayed and prayed for my obsession to stop, but my prayers were never answered. In January of this year, 2016, I stumbled to the mirror, filthy drunk and half crazed. I looked into it and asked, who had I become? Why wouldn't the Creator help me? Then it occurred to me, why would the Creator help me if I couldn't even admit I was an alcoholic? I saw the horror in my face, and at that moment I accepted who I was and all the things I had done. Addiction doesn't discriminate. It doesn't care who you are, what your blood quantum is, what kind of family you come from, if you're intelligent, if you're poor or wealthy, woman or man, young or old. Addiction isn't just my personal disease. It's a family disease, a community disease, and people don't have to die from this disease. We need to care about ourselves and for others. If I could help people understand what addiction feels like by rolling up the deep and dark addiction spirit that crushes and shatters lives and let people carry it around for a week in the pit of their stomach, I would, but I can't. I can only share the horrific experience of almost losing my life and losing my father to alcoholism on July 12th, 2016. I can still hear him say, honey, don't let this take you too. You are stronger than you think you are. When I look in the mirror now, I see a beautiful and sober woman, a mother of three, and the daughter of loving parents.
Just leave, your presence still lingers here, and it won't.